factor each trinomial into the product of two binomials. Check the result. Now, in these examples, we have a trinomial that we're beginning with where the lead coefficient is not 1. So, for example, we have a lead coefficient of 3 in this example, a lead coefficient of 2 in this example. Now, when that happens, we're going to factor using another method, which is often called the AC method or the AC and grouping method. All right, so the first step is factor out the GCF. That should always be your first step in factoring. Second, we're going to find the product A times C. Third, we're going to find the factors of A times C that add to B. Fourth, we're going to rewrite the B term using the pair of numbers found in step 3. That's going to give us a 4-term polynomial, which we will factor by grouping. All right, so let's see an example. A, we have 3x squared minus 7x minus 20. There's no GCF, so let's find the product AC. Now remember, in this situation, A is 3, B is negative 7, and C is negative 20. So let's do a little side work. A times C would be 3 times negative 20 is negative 60. We wish to find a pair of numbers now. Find the factors of AC that add to B. Find the factors of AC that add to B. All right, so let's work with 60. What are the factors of 60? 1 and 60. Well, let's go with negative 1 and 60. Negative 2 and 30. Negative 3 and 10. Negative 4 and 15. Negative 5 and 12. Negative 6 and 10. 7 doesn't work. 8 doesn't work. 9 doesn't work. And we're back to 10. So these are the possible factors. So let's see. Adding negative 1 and 60 is 59. Negative 2 and 30 is 28. Negative 3 and 10 is, I'm sorry, that should be negative 3 and 20. Negative 3 and 20 is 17. Negative 4 and 15 is 11. Negative 5 and 12 is 7. Wait a second, I wanted a negative 7. Since I wanted a negative 7, I'm going to change the signs. So instead of negative 5 and 12, let's go with 5 and negative 12. That would give me a sum of negative 7. That's the pairing that I like. So my magic numbers are 5 and negative 12. So now what I do is I rewrite the B term using that pair of numbers. So I'll rewrite the polynomial as 3x squared. Now instead of writing a minus 7x, I'm going to write plus 5x minus 12x. And then I still have a minus 20. Now I factor using grouping. So 3x squared plus 5x plus negative 12x minus 20. Greatest common factor of the first grouping is x, so I have x by 3x plus 5. Greatest common factor of the second grouping is negative 4, so I factor out a negative 4. Negative 4 times 3x is negative 12x. Negative 4 times positive 5 is negative 20. I have a greatest common factor of 3x plus 5 now, so I can write this as 3x plus 5 by x minus 4. I think that's my answer. Let's check with FOIL. 3x by x is 3x squared. Outers, 3x by negative 4 is negative 12x. Inners, positive 5 by x is plus 5x. Last, 5 times negative 4 is negative 20. Combine the like terms in the middle, and we get 3x squared minus 7x minus 20, and that checks out. Let's see another example. B, we have 2x squared minus x minus 15, so A is 2, B is negative 1, C is negative 15. No GCF, right? I can't factor out the 2, so let's move to this AC and grouping method. All right, so A times C is negative 30. 2 times negative 15 is negative 30. So let's list some factors of 30. See, negative 1 and 30, negative 2 and 15, negative 3 and 10, 4 doesn't work, 5 works, negative 5 and 6, and then I would get to 6, and 6 times 5, and then you're just going in the other direction. So let's find some sums. Negative 1 plus 30 is 29, negative 2 plus 15 is 13, negative 3 plus 10 is 7, negative 5 plus 6 is 1. Wait a second, I wanted negative 1, so let me change the signs. 5 times negative 6 is negative 30. 5 plus negative 6 is negative 1. That's the pairing that I want. Alright, so I rewrite this. 2x squared plus 5x minus 6x minus 15. Grouping. All right, so I regrouped. Oop, that should be minus 15 there. All right, so now using the grouping method, my common factor for the first two terms is simply x. So I have x by 2x plus 5. And for the second grouping, I can factor out a negative. So let me factor out a negative 3. That's the GCF, so negative 3 times 2x is negative 6x. Negative 3 times positive 5 is 15. Notice I do have that common binomial factor. So I can write the factored form as 2x plus 5 by x minus 3. I think that's the factored form. Let me check with FOIL. 2x times x is 2x squared. 2x times negative 3 is negative 6x. 5 times x is 5x. 5 times negative 3 is negative 15. Combining the like terms gives me a negative 1x, which checks out. All right, a couple more examples. Here we have 5x squared minus 31x plus 6. All right, no common factor that I can take out. So let's go straight to the AC method. With A equal to 5, B equal to negative 31, and C equal to 6. All right, so let's see. First, AC. A times C, 5 times 6 is 30. Let's list factors of 30. 1 times 30, 2 times 15, 3 times 10, 4 doesn't work, 5 times 6. Now, 1 plus 30 is 31, and that's almost what we wanted. I needed a negative 31. Well, if I used a negative 1 and a negative 30, my sum would be negative 31, and that's the pairing that I want. Negative 1 times negative 30 is positive 30. Negative 1 plus negative 30 is negative 31. Okay, so I've got my pairing. We have 5x squared minus 1x minus 30x plus 6. Grouping. All right, 5x squared plus 1x, my common factor there is x, so I'd have x by 5x minus 1. In my second grouping, remember, if that lead number in the grouping is negative, you want to factor out a negative, so, and my common factor is 6, so I'll factor out a negative 6. Negative 6 times 5x is negative 30x. Negative 6 times negative 1 is positive 6. Let me just clean that up a little bit. Notice again, we have a common factor of 5x minus 1. So I can write this in factored form as 5x minus 1 by x minus 6. I'm pretty sure that's my factored form. Let me check with FOIL. 5x times x is 5x squared. Outer, 5x times negative 6 is negative 30x. Inner, negative 1 times x is negative 1x. Last, negative 1 times negative 6 is positive 6. The first and last terms work. Checking the middle terms, combining like terms, that's a negative 31x, and that checks out. And so I can be confident in my factored form. All right, last example, D, we have 6 plus 10x squared plus 19x. First thing we want to do here is rewrite this in descending order. So we have 10x squared plus 19x plus 6. Can I take out a common factor? No, there's no common factor, so let me go over and do some side work for the AC method. With A equal to 10, B equal to 19, and C equal to 6. A times C, 10 times 6 is 60. All right, factors of 60, 1 and 60, 2 and 30, 3 and 20, 4 and 15, 5 and 12, 6 and 10. Finding sums, 61, 32, 23, 19. Don't need to do anything with the signs here. We're very happy. All right, breaking up the B term, 10x squared plus, let's be consistent here, 10x squared plus 4x plus 15x plus 6. Grouping. All right, factoring out the GCFs. For the first grouping, 10x squared plus 4x, my common factor is 2x. So I have 2x by 5x plus 2. For my second grouping, 15x plus 6, I can factor out a common factor of 3, and that would leave a 5x plus 2. So I have a common binomial factor of 5x plus 2, and then I can write this as 5x plus 2 by 2x plus 3. Let me box that in, and let's check our work. Let's see, 5x times 2x is 10x squared. Outers, 5x times 3 is 15x. Inners, 2 times 2x is 4x. And last, 2 times 3 is 6. And the first and last work, right, 10x squared and 6, checking the middle term, 15x plus 4x is 19x, and that checks out.